at the western edge of Mount Elgon, Kapchorwa, is as remote as it is stunning. These rugged lands, hundreds of meters above sea level, are spectacular, breathtaking sights. But this beauty can be deceptive. Sebe is a region with deep thorny issues. The region is largely a victim of its own geography. The area's education, too, has also fallen victim to the ruggedness of the land. This is Ngangata Primary School in Kapchorwa District, as seen from a clifftop. It is a government-owned facility located in Kaptanya sub-county. 976 are enrolled here. They come from nearby villages and sub-counties, battling rough roads and the cold to attain an education.
We are asking government to come in to improve on this rate, because you'll find out that these are very hard areas to reach. Our children, teachers, travel very long distances. At times when it is rainy season, find that people come late to school, teachers and children. And of course, the teaching itself does not take root to the extent that it is required. So I urge government to come in to build more classrooms, improve on roads, and many other things that are associated with infrastructure.
The school has huge infrastructure gaps. Classrooms are overflowing with learners. We are told some pupils quit because they can't fight for seating space. There's also a huge human resource gap here. Out of the 27 teachers needed, only 17 are provided. This is a hard-to-reach area.
Many schools in Kapchorwa still remain hard to reach because of the mountainous nature of the land, but also in valleys like this, practices like female genital mutilation and early marriage still take place.
Ngangata is located in what authorities call the lower belt of Kapchorwa. This is especially unsafe for girls. Despite a ban on female circumcision, some parents use the remoteness of the land to perpetuate the harmful practice.
My name is Chesakit Shamira. I'm a senior woman teacher at Ngangata Primary School in Kapchorwa District. For our girls to stay in school, we need to counsel them, guide them, so that they may stop early marriages, getting interested in sugar daddies. Then also, they may stop also female genital mutilation and also early sex.
And as Uganda joins the rest of the world to mark Teachers Day today, Ngangata will be hoping for a change in the status quo around this time next year.